Hello, thank you for tuning in. You are tuned in to The Encourager, and my name is Nehru. I wanted to come on and do something, I guess, not a little different. It's right in line with what, you know, with what I'm called to do, and that is to help us to become the highest, purest, truest versions of ourselves possible. Life does that. And if we allow life to do that, then life does a pretty good job despite the challenges. Some of those challenges can be, you can use whatever phrase you want to use, heart-wrenching, catastrophic, tragic. You can use any one of those, wonderful and amazing and phenomenal and shocking and overwhelming. And yeah, you can use those words too. So you can use optimistic and pessimistic words. But today, thank you for tuning in, first of all, and if you're a first-time listener, thank you so much. The purpose of the channel is to be an encouragement, to help us, again, just as I said, become our best selves, and we can only do that, one, when we love ourselves unconditionally first. We can never, ever, rightfully, and people do it all the time, and they do it unknowingly, so they do it with an innocent ignorance. Okay, they do it because society has taught them to do things a certain way. Society doesn't teach us, hey, you need to filter through the people who come into your life. Society doesn't teach us that, because if society should teach, if you do that and you just allow people to come in and out of your space, your energy, your life, right, come into your aura, right? When you allow that, it changes for the better and for the not so much. Every time someone comes in or enters or leaves your life, it happens that way. Whether that is a physical leaving, so someone is no longer physically here in the 3D. Or if someone, you decide that, you know, okay, I've had enough and I'm going to move on, I'm going to call it quits on this, whatever type of ship it happens to be, relationship, sex ship, love ship, companionship, marriage ship, whatever it happens to be, okay? But society, and this is part of what I'm here for, is to change that, to help us, again, to become more consciously aware, because most people live their lives unconsciously. That's why people wake up and do the same thing over and over again every single day. They go to the same place for their coffee. They make the coffee at the same time. And there's no deviation. And so when that happens and there's no change, stagnation sets in. Okay. And so if you're one who've been wondering, oh, I've been at this job for 10 years and it's stagnant, change needs to probably happen. Whether that's change on your part, maybe that's getting a certificate, maybe that's looking for another opportunity that's not provided at your current place of employment. Perhaps that's looking for another opportunity within the same company, but in another department, right? You have to sift through all of that information or all of those options. You have to sift through all of that. And the best way to do that, in my opinion, is through some type of form of meditation and stilling yourself. Okay? And that is stilling, not stealing, okay? So stilling yourself, being still. And being still does a lot of things. It, one, stops the subconscious from going so fast, right? So the unconscious mind that's running, I got to go get the kids, I got to do this, I got to do that, I got to go do this, I got to go do that. And then you finally lay down at 11:30 at night, realizing you haven't had a minute for yourself all day. You wake up at 6:30 in the morning, 6 o'clock in the morning, 5 o'clock in the morning, and you do the same thing all over again. Where is the personal love? And this is how we get away from our true selves. And again, life happens. However, the way we go about managing it, we control how fast that water flows out of the faucet. Okay? We control that. We control that with our actions. We control that with our choices. We all have free will. You might think you're confined to a place or a person, but trust me, you're not. there's either spiritual means or legal means, man's laws, that will allow you to get out of a situation. So at some point, you know, you have to do things that is best for yourself. So today I want to talk about, after that, I don't know how many minute long intro. So today I would actually like to share a little bit about Ascended Masters. And Ascended Masters being, now there are many Ascended Masters, but there are most speak of, most books and things speak of like 7 to 9, they might mention 10 Ascended Masters, okay? So I'm going to mention the common Ascended Masters that most of us are familiar with, and I think, so the Ascended Masters are, and I'll go into a little bit of explanation about each of them as after I mention their names. So Mother Mary, the Mary of Jesus. Yes, she was the Mary of Jesus, the mother of Jesus, of Yeshua. Here in the 3D, she's an Ascended Master. Buddha is an Ascended Master. Yeshua is in a Buddha, Jesus Christ. He is an Ascended Master. Wan Yin is an Ascended Master. Kali is an Ascended Master. Krishna is an Ascended Master. Lakshmi is an Ascended Master. Merlin is an Ascended Master. And Saint Germain is an Ascended Master. And so, again, this is not an exhaustive list. Again, there are Ascended Masters that walk among us today, okay, and are with us today. And so you get to be an Ascended Master, or you get to that point after several lifetimes of clearing out karmic debt is the way that you, and you have to, that is an ego kind of graduation. So after many lifetimes, and one has done away with their ego, and they're fully able to function in whatever place. And when I say place, I mean specifically anointing, but anointing is a rather light word for what angelics do or what they have, what they embody. So anointing's kind of light. But their giftings, their abilities given by Divine Most High, these individuals often go through multiple lifetimes of dealing with karmic debt before they get to a place to where they ascend and get into that I guess unique spiritual place, right? They're all unique spiritual places. If you're an archangel, it's a unique spiritual place, and there are many archangels, and so on and so forth. So Ascended Masters are souls who have ascended beyond the need to incarnate here on earth. Okay, so an Ascended Master is someone who has lived their last time here in the physical 3D earth. I know for me, this is, regardless of whatever, I don't shoot for titles. For those of you who are listening to me at any point in time prior to today is 11/13/23. For those of you who have listened to any part of any of my messages prior to that, or prior to this one, you know that there are a lot of things I do internally to check myself, right? To make sure I'm not functioning from an egoic nature, okay? But I do know for a fact that this is my last 10th and final time here. I said yesterday in the video that I shared that anyone who's hoping to have another chance with me, and I specifically said that for the stalkers and doppelgangers who are listen to these the things that I post, because they think they can use it as weaponry when in fact they have no bullets, and I'm the sniper. So with that, again, I check myself. I don't do anything from an egoic standpoint. outside of being bold about who I am and what I'm here to do, because no one can ever talk me out of that, right? Everybody can be against me. And in fact, up until this point, in my own perspective, in some way, everyone who has been close to me is or was against me at some point, right? So you know the story of my father and my mother. If you don't know that story, go back to earlier videos. You'll see videos entitled Polygamous Family, My Polygamous Family, Growing Up in That Situation. And so you'll hear that. You can know more about that story in those videos. Dark Night of the Soul, Twin Flame Relationship, I've been through it all. Rare autoimmune virus, man still has no cure for, only diagnosed or only recognized by the medical industry since 2010. So it's like a brand new yesterday disease. It's like polio showing up last week. They have no answer for it. Okay? But healing came through the way of a kidney transplant because the autoimmune virus attacked attacked both of my kidneys. And so that kidney transplant was on 7/7/17. I always like to mention a date because synchronicities are extremely important. So ascended masters are souls who have ascended beyond the need to incarnate here on Earth. They may appear on Earth in human form as healers, prophets, or teachers, but this is not for their own soul growth. Instead, and I know for a fact, for me, I'm not justifying anything here, right? But I know for me, I am a healer. Again, I give many examples of that probably in every video I mention at some point in time, right? Because I know that that's why I'm here. I am here. I show up in people's lives when healing is needed. That's who I am. That's what I do. So if we should happen to meet each other, I would shake your hand and say hello. Let's get to healing, right? That would not be a bad introduction or an incorrect one. So again, that's just what I'm gifted to do, right? I'm not gifted to play a professional sport, right? That's just not me. I am 5'9", and probably 150 something. Probably. I don't think I weigh 160 pounds. So. But I am, again, I take care of myself. So I'm fit. I exercise. In fact, I exercise this morning. I exercise most every day. I'm not 6'6", 200, 200 pounds and playing in the NBA. That wasn't the road that I was to go down. So we all have our own path, right? And our own gifts, our own anointings, our own impartations spiritually from divine in regards to what we're supposed to do. I'm a healer. Okay? So this is not for their soul's growth. Instead, it is for the benefit of humankind. Over many years, so many people have called on these masters that it lends them energy, and they become spiritual figureheads that we can also call upon for assistance and support, so on and so forth. So Mother Mary, most of us know that Mother Mary is the mother of Yeshua, Jesus Christ. Okay, Mother Mary is an ascended master from the Catholic and Judeo-Christian religions. Therefore, many Catholics represent with this energy around them. This is why the Catholic Church focuses so much on Mother Mary, right? Mother Mary also accompanies those whose life purpose is to work with children and to help children in some way. Mother Mary helps with all issues relating to children, including fertility, parenting, and adopting. So it is not surprising that parents and mothers in particular often represent this energy around them. Mother Mary is an archetype of the ideal mother. She's kind, nurturing, sincere, patient, and has a loving energy. Okay. And so, yeah, so the Catholic Church focuses on Mother Mary. And one thing that the Catholic Church and most every religion does is they really do not give praise to whom praise is due. So the religious organizations in the world, they focus on Jesus. That is wrong. That is incorrect. That is incorrect. You do not pray to Jesus. You do not pray to Jesus. No, 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 no. You do not pray to Jesus. You pray to Most High, Yahweh, right? Not Yeshua, Yahweh. You pray to Most High, Divine Source. That is not Jesus. Okay? He's one of the Ascended Masters, right? But he is not the Creator. He is not the Divine Creator. He is not. Okay? Just like your son or daughter is not you. They are a close replication, replica, but replication. But they are not you. Okay? It's that close, but they are not you. And in fact, that is even closer because, like the seahorse, he is all encompassing, right? Yahweh, Most High is, right? And so that makes his connection to Yeshua that much more special. However, I mean, compared to a father, son, mother, son, father, daughter, mother, daughter type of relationship here on earth. Okay? All right. But no, we do not pray to Jesus. Okay? No. Because he's interceding on your behalf. We do not pray to him. We go to the source. That's where religion has it wrong. Okay? So Buddha. The name Buddha means the enlightened or awakened one. Moderation is a key teaching in the Buddhist spiritual tradition. Therefore, one can evoke Buddha whenever help is needed with balancing, finding the middle path. Buddha's energy is helpful in situations and life lessons where moderation is required. Other energies associated with Buddha include love, respect, dignity, and peace. Buddha's presence is wise and serene energy. Okay? Jesus. Jesus is unconditional love. My healing power is unconditional love. Okay? So I know that him and I are closely related spiritually, because again, that is why I'm here. That is my healing power. Is my unconditional love. And I forgive easily. I don't hold grudges. I've had women be unfaithful to me. I've been involved with women who were married or involved in relationships and I was unaware of them. I've had women, I forgive them. Father took my first wife. Forgive them. Forgave her. Forgave all of them. My daughter didn't want anything to do with me at the age of 14 because she was brainwashed. Right? Forgive her. Right? I forgive easily. But at the same time, I will say this. My anger is severe, if that makes sense. So I love unconditional. My agape love, it has no respect of persons. It's given freely, right? But my love that comes from the emotional place, that has boundaries around it, okay? Right? Because within that is my time within that wall, and I'm just now seeing this and describing it. So within those walls, right, of my emotional self is the emotional love, the physical intimacy, the vulnerability, right? All of those are within that wall now. They weren't always, but now they're within that wall. Then the agape love is on the outside of that wall, because the agape love is for everyone, right? But my anger is severe. It's homicidal. It's deathly. The from this wounded warrior, the rage from this blue star angel or Blu-ray angel, and so it's rare that I get that way, and I share that with you again just so that you know there's both sides. Okay, it's not all just all fluffy, right? All right. So yes, the Ascended Master Jesus, with whom most are familiar, having spent many lifetimes in their Christian faith. So again, many of us, most of us, are here for the whatever number of times. Most of us are not here for the very first time in this lifetime on this planet. Yes, there's life in other planets. Yes, we have, many of us have spent time in those other places as well. Okay, I can't go into all that because I will get off track, and it's easy for me to do. Because I enjoy what I do. So Wan Yin, okay? So Wan Yin is a Buddhist goddess. Her name means she who hears prayers. Her energy is characterized by compassion. She represents feminine power and beauty. Wan Yin also teaches harmlessness, i.e. doing no harm, and has a fierce and protective aspect to her energy. Okay, Kali. Kali is another ascended master. Kali is an ascended master, is a Hindu goddess associated with death, endings, transformations, and destructions. Her nickname is the Dark Mother. So when you are going through the dark night of the soul, you are working with Kali, and Kali is working with you, okay? I always think of the Indiana Jones, I think it was the Temple of Doom, Indiana Jones and the Lost Ark, Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom. I think it was the Temple of Doom. When, excuse me, when the, he was in this, he had found his way into this ancient cave, and these ancient people who was looking for the three whatever stones and all of that, right? And he was, it was the one with Shorty in it and then the blonde chick. I don't know her. I don't remember her name. But the characters, the Asian character's name was Shorty in that movie. I think it was the Temple of Doom. But anyway, at one point when the evil deity or representation of it is standing there, and he's about to take the heart out of someone, and he starts saying Kali Ma, and he starts going crazy and shaking and chanting and all of that. Always think of that whenever I think of this that here, right? And it's ironic because in that situation, death was imminent. Whoever that, I don't know, remember who was like getting ready to have their heart removed from them or something, but that represents death. Endings, right? That is a transformation. Death, whether physical or spiritual, is a transformation, right? And that involves destruction. If it's a physical death, the destruction obviously is the ending of the 3D life. But if it's a spiritual destruction, then that destruction speaks to, again, the ego and that man-made false security and worthiness. It's a false sense of worthiness is what that ego nature is. So Kali's energy is intense, ferocious, determined, and courageous. She encourages us to live fearlessly and has a reputation for being available to help us destroy that which no longer serves us. Call on Kali when you need help dismantling something in which life no longer benefits you. Excuse me. I often speak of cord cutting, okay? And so if you're having issues removing people from your energy, call on Kali, and Kali will help you when you're meditating, you're doing your yoga, you're doing your still time, your quiet time, right? S-T-I-L-L time. When you're doing that, right? Call on Kali, and Kali can help you with the removal of individuals that are in your energy field, within you feel them because they're sending evil eyes or spell work or witchcraft towards you. Maybe they just don't like the way you work, even though you're efficient and excellent, or they don't like you because you excel, you're an overachiever or whatever they're jealous reasons might be, or envious reasons might be, right? Or it could not be that. It could just be a person who you realize no longer serves your good. That season, their time with you have run its course. Most relationships run their course. Most relationships aren't meant to last your entire lifetime. Most people hold on to relationships like they are a lifeline, and that is the reason why others keep man from achieving all that man can be, because man thinks that things are permanent in the 3D when in fact they are not. Okay? So Krishna is a Hindu deity. Krishna's energy can be defined by its joyful quality. His energy is warm, sweet, and loving. Some believe that Krishna helps with romantic relationships. He is often depicted in paintings and images with his partner, Radha. Okay? So, these individuals that the religious sect deems as different religions are actually not different religions. These individuals are all part of the Most High because there is only one, and we are all that one. I think it's Frankie Beverly and Maze made that song, "We Are One," right? I don't remember the rest of that song. No matter where we are, we are one. I don't remember that song. I don't know. Let me see if I can find that song. I'm going to play it. Let me see. But yes, so let's see here.
The real root cause of snoring is not what you think. Did you know that snoring has nothing to do with nasal?
So yes, we are one, that the energy. So, again, religion tries to tell you that something's right and wrong. The sooner religion realizes that there is no right or wrong, there's just karma and dharma, the better we will be. ...1983 this song came out. That year might be important for someone. 1983. Alright. We are one. That's the universe. That's Most High. That's the Ascended Masters. That's the Orishas. That's right. That's the light workers. That's the star seeds. That's your archangels. Yep. Archangel Michael, Archangel Raphael, Archangel Uriel, Archangel Ezreal, Archangel Ariel. Right? I wasn't planning on doing this, but let's enjoy it. These are karmic relationships. With the silly games we play. Yeah, right? So, in life, we really truly are. So that song says we are one. Why we continue to... I'm really truly trying to get away from profanity so much. So why do we truly... What's with the fuckery? There's no other way to... I have to... What's with the fuckery, right? So if we are one, what are we doing? Right? Why am I against you and looking at your skin color saying, I don't like you? I need to sit my dumb ass down. That's what I need to do if I have that thought. If I'm judging any part of you based on just the color of your skin, I need to go sit down somewhere. I really do. And you need to go sit down if that's your thought process towards anyone else. You need to reevaluate yourself. And you need to find out who you really truly are, right? Okay? So, again, these individuals, right? So Christianity would have you to believe that being a Hare Krishna, what that's not, he's an ascended master. He's approved by Most High. Stop being ignorant. Okay? Lakshmi is another ascended master, and that's spelled Lakshmi, okay, is the goddess of abundance and good fortune in the Buddhist and Hindu traditions. Her energy is found around those who are striving for abundance, including material abundance, emotional fulfillment, and good health, okay? Yesterday, I spoke on the difference between praying and manifesting, And there's nothing wrong with praying, but if you pray without ceasing and it just becomes a begging episode every time you pray, that is not honorable. He's not deaf, dumb, or mute. He's not going to respond. Okay? You have to come up with a better process, a different process. Okay? So, you might want to focus on or listen to meditations associated with Lakshmi, right? If abundant material abundance is something that you are seeking, and good health, okay? Emotional fulfillment. You're seeking those things. Emotional fulfillment also deals with your heart, okay? But it also deals with your root and your sacral chakra, okay? Because between your heart, your root chakra, and your sacral chakra, okay, that is between the love and the emotions, right? That's those three. That's where that comes from, okay? And then confidence comes from your solar plexus, which I think comes after the healing of your heart, your sacral, and you get grounded through your root chakra. Then the solar plexus chakra begins to shine, okay? And that, again, that's my perspective. Your experience might be different. Next is Merlin. Merlin is an ascended master. And there is some question about whether or not Merlin was actually a physical being. The others there certainly are, and there's many records to prove that. But there's questions about whether or not Merlin was or not. I have no say-so one way or the other in regards to that. It doesn't matter to me. My only purpose or my only question is, did they do their job in each lifetime that they were here? Apparently, the answer is yes. But Merlin, a sage and psychic, Merlin is said to have helped King Arthur during the 5th century Camelot in Wales. Some believe that Merlin is just a legendary figure, and others believe that he actually existed. Either way, Merlin can be called on for assistance. He represents the inner and subjective realm, internal strength and power, all forms of intuitive development. For this reason, you may find Merlin around psychics and those who are interested in metaphysical topics. Okay? I was walking out the other day and I found an Institute of Metaphysical Studies the other day. I didn't run across that for no reason. If you are on a path of psychic development, you might like to call on Merlin to help you on your path. Okay? So if you believe you are psychic or you know you are, if you know you are, but you've just been kind of hiding those. See, for me, that's part of what I've been doing, or I was doing for 46 years and 9 months, is I was really kind of subduing who I am now externally exposing to the world. For 46 years and 9 months, I subdued that. My journals show me I subdued that. All of the prophetic dreams that many have come to pass, some of which we are right in the moment, and some of them have not yet. The dreams, the healings, the events, just the miraculous moment, just, yeah, right? Undeniable that there's something going on within me that is psychic or sees past events and future events type of thing, right? And again, a lot of times that comes through my meditation and my dreams, certainly through my dreams since I was birthed this lifetime, okay? Saint Germain is one of my, is to me someone that I resonate with specifically. He's one of them. He's not the only one. But Saint Germain often shows up around those who have communication or healing as their life purpose. I did not read these things before. I rarely do that. Okay. Typically, if I'm led to do something, I just do it. And then, I don't know, just wait for the fruit to show, I guess, or something. Because I'm not trying to prepare a sermon. I don't need to do that. Why do I need to prepare what the Father has me to say if he's going to put the words on my tongue that I need to say when the moment I need to say them? Why do I need to prepare a sermon? Saint Germain often shows up around those who have communication or healing. And I understand guidelines, making points, but I don't need to have a 3-page sermon printed out. Where's the room for the prophetic? Huh? Where's the room for the miraculous to happen in your time with those people if you have your entire sermon written out? Really? What if Most High wanted to put a comma there and you put a period? Then what? Saint Germain often shows up around those who have communication or healing as their life purpose, as his role is to help us shed anything that hinders our self-expression and the expression of who we truly are in our lives. And that is my job this lifetime. Through my own life, through my own challenges, through my own victories, help others to see that you can be the truest, purest, highest form of yourself, and you can be in the world, but you can really kind of hover above the ground. Okay? You do not have to stay low vibration as many do, right? Archangels are angels of high rank, much like ascended masters, The prefix arch means chief or ruling. I have accessed my Akashic records, and there are many, many realms in existence in the universe. It's not so. We talk about the 3D and the 5D. And the 4D, okay, in the 4D is where all the battles are taking place. So between here and there, right, people think about heaven and earth, right? If you want to think about it that way, heaven is around you. Heaven is anywhere, right? It's wherever you make it. So anyway, it's not some far off distant place. So, yeah. So, accessing the Akashic records, again, this is done by ascending, again, being in aligned energetically, right? Everything's all buttoned up nice and cute, right? That's, you access your Akashic records that way, right? And by following the spiritual laws, all right? So don't be sending spell work to people who ain't did shit to you. That's not following a spiritual law. Don't be sending evil eyes to people who only love you, because all you're doing is racking up karma, okay? So again, many people don't realize this is why their life is shitty, because they have so much karmic debt, because their family, their choices, their kids, their companion, their whoever, right? Themselves more than anything, self, right? So, each realm holds a particular kind of energy that we associate with life here on Earth. Each realm does. Each realm, 5D, 3D, 4D, 6D, 7D, 8D, 9D, how many ever there are, right? They all have a unique association with life here on Earth, as well as life on other planets. And yes, there again, yes, there is. And each realm is ruled over by 7 archangels, respectively. Hence, we tend to associate a certain archangel with a certain type of energy, and we can call on each one of them for a specific purpose. So let's take a look at the archangels. And as far as the archangels are concerned, I'm going to be speaking on 8 of them: Archangel Michael, Archangel Raphael, Archangel Gabriel, Archangel Uriel, Archangel Metatron, Archangel Samuel, Archangel Azrael, and Archangel Zophiel. Okay, so I'm going to be speaking on those 8 today. Okay, so Archangel Raphael. Archangel Raphael brings energy of healing, gentleness, and love. He helps with to soothe broken hearts and to heal our wounds. Call on Raphael if your heart feels a bit tender and you need some gentleness. So when I was going through my dark night of the soul and I was being purged of all the gunk that was in my heart, right? I called on Archangel Raphael often, daily, in that time. Daily. Yeah, daily, I did. And still do. Still do. Yep, still do. But then, right, it was big time because he's the heart healer, right? He's the love healer. Okay? Archangel Gabriel. Archangel Gabriel is the archangel of writers and communication. She is the only archangel depicted as a woman and mentioned in both the Old and New Testament. Okay? So, if you need to communicate a message personally or professionally, call on Archangel Gabriel. Okay? Archangel Gabriel. And this is how people can telepathically communicate. Because our angels carry our messages. Archangel Gabriel can also help with motivation. Or that's one way. Help with motivation and confidence. As in all areas related to children. Okay. So if you're having issues with your children, they're lacking motivation or confidence, maybe, right? Or they're being bullied, right? That's a big one. They're being bullied. Right, and they're needing some self-confidence. Call on Archangel Gabriel to help your child with being feeling less than equal to everybody else in their class or everybody else in their school because they are. And chances are, based on my own experience, if they're the one getting picked on, they're actually the one who's strong, and the bully is the weak one. I'm not a psychiatrist or a psychologist, but that just makes spiritual sense to me. Because the spiritually good-hearted people are not the bullies. Those are the karmic kids. Karmic kids. Yes, kids. Kids. Kids that unalive their friends, unalive their parents. Unalive their parents because of a dumbass boyfriend or girlfriend who convinced them to do so. Karmic kids. Karmic. Right? Call on Archangel Gabriel so that he can help your child, one, no longer be a bully if your child happens to be a bully, okay? And if they're needing to stand up for themselves and they're needing a little confidence, there's nothing wrong with that. Definitely stand up for yourself, right? I would teach my kids, you don't start it, but you better finish it. So somebody come up to you and they're starting stuff, hey, they touch you, it's game on. You don't even have to say anything else. Just start swinging. You don't even have to say anything else. You don't need any justification from me, and there will be no punishment. Yep, because it's justified. Archangel Uriel, and no, I don't teach my kids to start fights. If you heard what I first said, I said that they did not start it. They're not instigators, and they were not taught to be so, and I would never do that. But if someone doesn't know, and they don't realize because they're ignorant, yep, and they step into the ring with you, hey, they threw the first punch. I just threw the next nine. That's not my fault. You know what I'm saying? Archangel Uriel is great to call on for emotional healing. He can help with difficult relationships, illuminating situations, and enabling us to see through feelings that we can make or that can make us feel stuck, such as judgment or anger. Archangel Uriel can also help with studies, tests, meetings by inspiring us with ideas. So Archangel Uriel works heavy with the sacral chakra. And I'm just seeing this, right? I didn't put this together before I started reading it. So just knowing what the chakras, the main seven chakras do, I'm seeing that. Right. And Archangel Metatron. Archangel Metatron is one of my, I shouldn't say favorite, but I especially, he's one of the archangels I especially enjoy working with, okay? So Archangel Metatron can be called on, again, for healing. I didn't read this before, literally. I did not read this, right? It looked like decent explanations for everything, so I just scrolled back up to the page and I just pressed record and started reading. But again, here we are. So what you're drawn to, this is what I'm seeing even for myself as I look at this. Look at what you're naturally drawn to. Are you naturally drawn to the arts, but you are a mechanic, right? If we pay attention to our life, it's been giving us signals since our birth date. It's been giving us signals since the beginning, right? People always told me I was an old soul. I sure am. I am. I've lived many lifetimes. Just here alone, I've lived, this is my 10th one, right? People always call on me for advice. I need help with this. Can you help me with this? About their kids and stuff. Kids. My own daughters don't really care for me because I'm this odd, weird person, right? So, but people do. They're just drawn to me for that way, for the whatever they think I can provide them. And again, this helps when I started to see clearly, helped me to step into who I really truly am called to be here, right? And that is a spiritual teacher, and that is a healer, right? Whether that healing comes through a physical body, right? Or that healing comes through supernatural means, and there's something energetically that needs to be healed. It doesn't matter, right? Healing is healing in whatever form it comes in, okay? But this specifically, again, he speaks to me because of what I know I'm here to do. One of these other archangels probably speaks to you specifically because of what you know you're here to be drawn to. And I encourage you. I was thinking about an Ice Cube song. Is it Jack in the Box? Where he says, don't let your motherfucking talent go to waste, right? Don't let your talent go to waste. Okay? You're here for a reason. You're here for a purpose. Let's get after it. Let's get after it. Okay? So back to Archangel Metatron. Archangel Metatron can be called on for healing and to help clear lower energies and replace these energies with higher vibrations. He can also help us find balance in everything we do, reminding us to give and receive in equal measure and keep our boundaries in place. I mentioned the things for me that are within my emotional heart boundary walls, and then there's agape love that's on the outside of that everyone sees, the stranger sees when they're standing in line at the grocery store, right? That's what they see, right? Archangel Metatron watches over sensitive children as well as indigo and crystal. I am an indigo souls, helping to ease any social anxiety or fear, okay? Also, indigo is associated with the third eye. Indigo is associated with the third eye. So Archangel Metatron, third eye, again, putting the puzzle pieces together. Okay. Archangel Shamuel is the angel of peaceful relationships. He can be called on to help us find the strength and willpower to face challenging, rather small or large, or challenges, excuse me, whether small or large. As he can see the connection between all things, Archangel Shamuel can also be called on to help us find items that are lost. So if you are in a karmic relationship, no matter what type of ship it is, again, doesn't matter. If you are in a karmic relationship, call on Archangel Shamuel during your meditation. Again, yoga, still time, whatever, however you spend your self time. If you don't have self time, let's start there, because you need self-time, okay? It's a must. You have to have that time. Whether it's, you might have to get up 30 minutes earlier than everybody else in the morning now in order to have your self-time, because that is the only time you have 29 minutes and 59 seconds to squeeze in. Do it, do it, do it. It's going to be worth it. It's going to be worth it. It's going to change your days, okay? Yes, so that's Archangel Shamuel. Archangel Azrael. Archangel Azrael is sometimes referred to as the Archangel of Death or the Angel of Death, although his name actually means whom God helps. Archangel Azrael guides souls who have newly crossed over assisting them through this transition. He also provides support to loved ones who may be grieving for the one who, this doesn't say this, before the one who, obviously, who has transcended, who's passed, right, transitioned. Archangel Azrael, right, so he helps with mourning and that sort of thing, right, loved ones that have passed, can assist during these times of transition, whether this form may, whatever form this may take. He is a great archangel for those working within counseling professions or support roles to call on. Okay. Archangel Michael, most are familiar with this one most of all. Archangel Michael is a spiritual protector and warrior. He is often depicted armed with a sword given to him by God. Archangel Michael was the archangel placed at the Garden of Treasures when Adam and Eve were removed from the Garden of Eden because they followed the serpent, right? And so when they were kicked out, right, and the cherubim was placed in front of the door with the sword, it was Archangel Michael that was there. At least at some point, that was assigned that position to guard that, right? And so Archangel Michael is a guardian. He is a protector. So if Archangel Michael is in your life, Archangel Michael is a protector of your life. You might have another protector, but if it's Archangel Michael, then you know that that's his position as your protector. Okay. Archangel Zophkiel, and that's spelled Zophkiel, helps with the art of creativity. Again, so this helps, again, there's the sacral chakra, the creativity, the artistic individual. If you are a musician, Archangel Zophkiel is going to be extremely important to you, no matter what type of artist you are, musician, songwriter, you paint, you draw, you're an illustrator, you're an actor, you're an actress, any arts, okay? Helps us to bring beauty into the world. I do oil and acrylic painting, right? I don't do it to sell. I do it for pleasure and expression. I think just for those reasons, expression and, yeah, illuminating maybe. Yeah, illuminating some things, because there are things that I see in paintings when they're done that stand out to me, whether they're images that I meant to paint or not, and that happens. It is usually recommended to call on Zophkiel if you need help with a creative project or you're redecorating your home. Zophkiel can also help us to bring more balance into our lives and help us with issues of perfectionism. So if you're having an issue of being, it's not good to be a perfectionist. That is a heavy burden to carry, because nothing's ever going to be exactly right. There is no such thing as man can never draw an exact straight line. It is absolutely impossible. Man cannot draw a straight line. I knew that when I was a kid. And I don't even know where I heard that. Maybe I didn't hear it. Maybe it's just a revelation. Man can never draw a straight line. Only nature can. Only Yeshua. I mean, only Yahweh, only Most High. Although archangels and ascended masters are often associated with certain religions, right, you do not have to be religious to call on any of these beings. Again, you don't have to be Catholic to call on Mother Mary. Okay? You don't have to be. Because Mother Mary is an ascended master. And again, we are one. All right? We are one. We just have to stop fighting against ourselves. We are one. Allow yourself to be your highest, purest, truest version of yourself. Possible. Allow yourself to be that. If someone was to ask you, you would say yes. Excuse me, when you arrive here, do you want to be the truest, purest, highest version of yourself? Absolutely. You would say yes. So what's the issue? The others around you, and what has been instilled in you over your how many ever how many ever years you've lived in this natural life this time, that is what the issue is. So it's the family traditions that are lifeless, but we still do them. It's the friends that mean nothing to you because their energy is blah. It's garbage, right? And all they do is complain about relationships, yet you're trying to create and manifest a new relationship. How are you going to manifest a prosperous relationship when all you do is hear from friends that are in garbage, shitty relationships? You can't do that. It's not going to happen. If you go into the bar, sooner or later, you're going to buy a drink. It's just the way it goes. Okay? It's just the way it goes. Okay? So, you've been tuned into The Encourager. I think that's it. Thank you so much for sticking in. I don't know where we are for time. Right at 55 minutes. It's always around 50 minutes or so that I, maybe that's what I average, 50 minutes. So thank you so much again for tuning in. My name is Nehru, and I hope you've gotten something out of what I've shared. Perhaps some of the Ascended Masters or the Archangels that I've mentioned, you can now call upon to help you in your unique specific situation, because we're all going through different things. Even if you and your friend are going through a breakup, or you and your friend are now looking for employment, or you and your friend have had to deal with the loss of a child, or that's heavy, you know, had to deal with the loss of whatever that is, just know that, one, your environment matters, and there is spiritual help that man has deemed in many cases as wrong, right? Or the enemy, right? But the truth of the matter is, there's a reason why they took 45 books out of your Bible and you only have 66 and not 111 at a minimum. There's a reason, because man's not interested in humans becoming their highest, truest version of themselves. Only Most High is. Only these Ascended Masters are. Only the Orishas are. Only your Archangels are. Only the light workers who help you. Only your starseed workers. Those are the only ones who are interested in you becoming your purest, highest, truest version of yourself. And those are the only ones you should be concerned about with as far as this journey is concerned. And that might sound harsh, but the reality again is that seasons come and go. And if we remove our emotional selves from situations, we can better logically deal with them. So if we remove ourselves emotionally from our friends, our bestie, right? And if we come to the realization that I can enjoy my coffee without going over to their house every day and listening to them complain about their husband or their wife. You know what, today? I think I'm going to drive by myself. I'm not going to carpool because I just want that time for me, you know? And I know we laugh and joke and we good time, blah, blah, blah. And we complain and talk about the bosses at the job that we're about to go to for the 12th year that we hate. We've been complaining about since year 3. Like, really? What kind of life is that? What kind of life is that? Change is inevitable. They say there's only two things that are certain. Actually, taxes are not certain. I was a tax accountant for 13 years. There are ways to legally get around paying taxes. Yes, there are, right? You have to have certain entities set up. You have to have certain structures in place, like trusts and things that allow you to not pay taxes for generations. You have to have those things set up. However, you do not,